sorry.
I don't know who's gonna come on. I feel like I'm like I'm struggling. I'm butchering this this live here. Hopefully, I think it might be a Wi-Fi, so we'll just go live. I don't know if anybody's gonna pop over. She's asleep. I don't know who's gonna come on. So I'm so sorry. I think it's a Wi-Fi issue. It looked like I had Wi-Fi, but then it kind of kept cutting off. So that was a little anticlimactic. I apologize for that. there's somebody. Oh, hey, Douglas. Thanks for coming back on. I'm sorry about that. There's three act. Well, this is the actual one. You guys made it to the actual one. You're here. Yay. Okay, I'm back. And I don't know if it cuts off. I know. Not again. If it cuts off suddenly, I think it's a Wi-Fi issue. It was like, it went like gray and was like unable to connect. But it was right when I was going to show you her. So I thought I had pressed something, but yeah, we're back. Yeah, welcome back, everybody. Yeah, that was a little bit clumsy. And then, high wisdom of mine. Take three. And then I went live and it happened again. So now I'm like a little nervous that at any point, hi, Carol. Ruby went to sleep. She's, I'm hesitant to show, she's... Can you see her little head? That's Ruby. So she crawled up under the pillow and went to sleep. Yeah, sorry about that. We were getting some momentum going too with the other live, and she's so... Should we play the game? Yes, she's sweet. Yeah. So, but I'm glad that we're back. I did eat some cake while I was trying to figure it out. So I think I was a little like stressed out, but, Ruby is, headbands, this game. Ruby's, she was from the paper. Well, Craigslist, but not the paper. Well, I feel old. Not the paper, Craigslist under, community. There's pets, and I just look in there and see kind of like at animals and stuff. And there was an ad for free puppies, and it just all worked out. So that's where she came from. She's from Bakersfield. And it was two people that had two dogs. And hi, Cowboy Hat Gaming. So yeah, let's try this. Hopefully it won't. Thanks for hitting the thumbs up button. Where am I from exactly? Like longitude and latitude coordinates? hi, Melissa. You're a new subscriber, Christina. Well, welcome. Hi, Amber. I'm from the Pacific Northwest, Sela. But I grew up in lots of different places. But that's kind of home, Pacific Northwest. I believe so, Maury. I haven't checked. I checked a few days ago and there were still four of them. So I haven't looked recently, but yeah, I hope so. I hope so. They were going to keep one. There were eight puppies and they were going to keep one. You're looking at all my videos to catch up. You love my channel. Well, thank you. Oh, you sent an email about the beanies. Awesome. Okay, cool. Yeah. So I will say that the beanies, please be patient with me because, I'm figuring it out. And I have to make some, but I'm feeling like that would be good for me right now is to crochet. Cause it's like, so it helps just like calm me down. And it helps if I'm feeling overwhelmed to kind of ground me. So, I would love to be doing some more crocheting. You're back, Natasha. Excellent. Rose, is you're new here and you're enjoying the relaxing channel. Thank you. Well, welcome. Welcome to the channel. And I'm glad that you find the videos relaxing. Hi, Danielle. Fingers crossed that it won't shut off. Yeah. Hey, Mel. No more buffering. Yay. Oh, Mandy, thank you. Thank you for that. Ruby's Health Vet Funds. Thank you so much. That'll come in handy. Yeah, she's going Tuesday to... So PetSmart has a vet in their... what's separate, but it's in the building. And then it's like Banfield. And so then any PetSmart around the country, I can take her to. So she's going to get going... I'm getting like a year of puppy care. It includes, you know, unlimited visits and her shots and anything that she'll need. So that's starting on Tuesday. Your dog Blue says hi. Nice. Hi, Blue. you like watching my channel in the morning? It starts your day. Wow, Christina. I love that. Yeah. Yeah, crocheting is very therapeutic. Yep. Yeah. Hey, Douglas. It's good to see people that made it over. Thanks for hopping over. Take my time. New to the channel. You love the vibe. Have a phenomenal Sunday. Thank you, Cheryl. Welcome to the channel. I appreciate that. You'll help me make some beanies? Awesome. Oh, I'm calming to listen to? Well, thank you. I appreciate that. Women supporting women. Thank you, wisdom of mine. Love that. Thank you very much for the super chat. Yeah. When's my birthday? My birthday's in May. Yeah, and my birthday's in May. I'm a Taurus. Hi, Trisha. Hey, my new friend. How are you from West Virginia? I'm doing well. Yeah, I had a cold and it really kind of like ran me down for a little bit. And then also during that time, I got a new puppy. So I don't know. I just took on a lot during a time where I was like resting, but I'm adjusting to it all. I'm doing well. I do feel a little overwhelmed sometimes, but I think I'm going to slow down a little bit with my kind of distance that I travel and just kind of, as I get towards the Pacific Northwest, I'm going to just really take some time. That's home, that land, the trees, the forest, and I'm excited to do some hiking and just ground and slow down. And I think that will feel kind of like grounding. So, yeah, I'm doing well and I'm looking forward to some of that. Yeah. You're a Taurus too, Ark Rosebud. Nice. And Bridget, you're a Taurus. I missed a super chat. I think I didn't, or maybe not. It just popped up. Oh yeah. Women supporting women. I love that. Yes. It disappeared from the top, but I did see it. Okay. What kind of dog? She's a lab and healer, and I think some other things too, but the dad was like a lab and the mom was a healer. Yeah. Oh, hi, you're from Korea and you love the channel. Thank you. Welcome to the channel. You love my glasses? Yeah. Thank you. They're from Amazon. They're pretty good. They're a little loose, so they kind of fall off a lot, but I need these. They're 1.5. My prescription's 1.75, but they only had 1.5 or 2, and I figured it was better to get a little under. But I need these for reading now, so sometimes I just end up wearing them so I don't lose them, so I can keep track of them. But I have another pair of glasses that's for driving and distance. And that's actually my specific prescription. These, so yeah, I guess bifocals at some point would be handy, but these work for now. Grounding is really good. It's like that Sedona video that I did. Like, I just want to do more and more and more of that. Like, slowing down, building fires, cooking, yeah, crocheting. you're a Taurus too, Madeline? Yeah, I'm getting international. Woohoo! and your husband, yeah. So you and your husband are Tauruses. That's cool. Yeah, can be interesting at times. Yeah, Tauruses can be headstrong and stubborn it's a good thing. The determination is a good thing because it's like, nope, I'm going to do this, even if I do it slowly and just one foot in front of the other. And but that determination, I can imagine that, yeah, stubborn. But I bet you enjoy the same things. Yeah, Pacific Northwest. Woohoo! I love the Pacific Northwest. Thank you, Debbie. You said you're glad I'm feeling better from England. Thank you. You're a Taurus too, JC Colin? Yeah. Awesome. Yeah, grounding is very good. Thank you, Lena. You love the channel. I'm an amazing person. Thank you. You as well. We're planning a trip to the Redwoods. Have you ever been? I have been. I have been, and I'm looking forward to spending some more time there. Not exactly sure when, but could be pretty soon. Yeah, the Redwoods. I love the Redwoods. I would need to explore the Redwoods a little more because in terms of like free camping, I'm not as familiar with places. So that can be a little challenging. But yeah, I'd like to explore the Redwoods more. You thought you lost me again. No, I'm back, and fingers crossed that that we stay. And Ruby's napping, so hopefully we can play a game. I just want to get caught up and say hello to everybody that managed to get from that live over to this one now. Hi Bates from Maine. Nice. You love the new puppy. That's sweet. Hi Judy. Hi Cameron. Myra, you travel with your two dogs? Yeah, they're good travel companions. Oh, there's the gal with the infectious laugh. Oh, thanks. I never even really thought about my laugh, but I'm glad that you guys enjoy it. My favorite thing to crochet is sweaters, but they're kind of tricky, but it's such a rewarding project to work on. It just takes a long time. Yeah, I don't know. I kind of like anything. It's fun to think of something and then try to make it. I don't really use patterns too much, except with the sweaters. Some of those, there's a video I have, and I did use some patterns with those sweaters just because it made it easier. But sometimes I'll just crochet. And that was the first time I really used patterns were those sweaters. And it was fun, but yeah. You're following the channel, Sela? Is it Sala or Sela? Sala? Well, welcome to the channel. Thank you for following the channel. The Redwoods do. They have campgrounds. Yeah. So I just have to, it was a while ago that a few years ago went and did some camping around there. And I just remember, it was when I had the van, the van that I converted, and I went with my son, and we went on a road trip for like 10 days. And I remember it was tricky to find camping or find like parking overnight. I think that we stayed in a Safeway parking lot one time, and that worked fine. And on the side of the road, like in the Redwoods another time, but it was just, I remember feeling a little like, but that was also a while ago, and I have much more experience now finding overnight parking. So it might be a whole different thing. And this is a little more stealth than the Dodge van. So your Basset Hound is named Ruby May. Aw, well, say hi to Ruby May, the Basset Hound. I love Basset Hounds. Hi, Susan from the mountains. Good to see you, too. Hello, Alana. Hi, Lizzie Marie. Oh, you like my laugh? I do like to sew. I do like to sew also. Yeah. Hand sewing is very slow, and I don't have a machine. When I was like 20, I got a treadle sewing machine that I had for a while, and I loved that. It was a little slow, but like one of those old treadles where you like use the treadle, and that was great. And it'd be fun to get one of those again someday. Or like a solar, you know, have a solar setup and have a sewing machine. And they also have tiny sewing machines now. Like I've seen like a handheld sewing machine that I was thinking one of those, but It was always my goal to make all my clothes, like all my clothes, all my dishes, all my sweaters. And so, yeah. I found that I'm not really at the point where I want to sew clothes right now, but I'd rather just like wear the same two outfits over and over again. But eventually it'd be fun to like make my own pair of jeans and make my own like rain jacket and things like that, that I wear all the time. Yeah, someday. I have sewn quilts, that I really liked, and yeah. That was a long time ago, and I don't have them. And then when my son was younger, I like baby quilts and stuff. Yeah. I'm sorry I'm missing some comments. I'm just, I get talking, and then, hi Josie Pops from Wales. hi Desert Moon from Northern California. Hi Zoe from Hampshire, UK. Hi K-True. It says, I love your channel and how practical and cute your setup is. Thank you. You missed how Ruby found me. Well, I kind of found her. We kind of, yeah. Thank you, Mandy. Yeah, I kind of, so that bird and just on my travels, I've just been tuning. I love animals. And so, I mean, you might be able to tell from the videos, like anytime, you know, if there's like a chipmunk nearby or birds. I've been having a lot of bird interactions, and I was just thinking about it more, and you know, like people have been commenting too, like, oh, you should get a dog, it'd be a great companion. And I think I was holding out to try to train my cat, which I did experiment with that a little bit last summer, having her with me, and it was tricky to have her along. So, but I think I was holding out to still try to do that. And then as time's gone by, I've realized like a dog would be so much easier. And my cat's happy. She's with my son and she's happy where she is. And once I have a larger vehicle, I think that I could make it work. Yeah. I think I could make it work in a larger vehicle with my cat and Ruby. But so I was just really kind of beginning to think, and so, you know, I like looking in the Craigslist under the pets to see there's so many different kinds of animals, and, a cool dog just walked by. but I did happen to look, and and there were some other, you know, situations where I was like, maybe I'll see about that puppy. And this just was like, green lights, and you know, it happened quickly, and I'm happy because it's the litter stopped. The mom didn't want to nurse them, you know, she kind of just got a point where she was like and done, like ready to wean. And so I'm glad that I can take care of Ruby, and she was really young, but she's, you know, she's not as young now, she's getting older. But yeah, that's kind of how we cross paths. Let's see. I'm missing a bunch of them, a bunch of comments. Yeah. Well, thank you, K-True. Yeah, I love animals. Yeah, I absolutely love animals. Oh, my Sharpie tattoo. Yeah, I love Sharpie tattoos as well. That'll be my next one, but that's going to be kind of pricey. But yeah, the swan. I want to do a swan here with strawberries. And I Sharpied it. There was a video where I Sharpied it on. And I had this one going for a little while before I got it, the Sharpie. So I kind of knew that's how I, and this one before I got this one, I'll Sharpie them on and leave them for a while and then kind of like fine tune the placement. I think at first this one was like more like this, and then I liked it lower down as I kept Sharpieing it on, so that when I'm ready to like go get it, I've like tested it out for a good 2 or 3 weeks. So yeah. Oh, almost lost connection. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Yeah. Sandra, you're new and don't know much of my story. Why am I living in the car and what do I do for income? So I have a video about why I'm living in my car. And also I'm going to be doing a Q&A coming up. That's going to be probably the next video. And I'm going to talk about food. I might get into a little bit about why I'm living in my car and a couple other things. But I do have a video, if you go back about 6 months, that talks about why I'm living in my car. And it's a pretty thorough explanation. There's that if you want to in the meantime. And what do I do for my income? I do DoorDash, and my YouTube channel was monetized in October, and so that's able to supplement the DoorDash. So I've been doing DoorDash for a few years, as well as the YouTube channel, but it wasn't until the monetization, it was in October, and then so like towards the end of November, there was some earnings from that came in. So that's what I do, and that's how I travel around. The DoorDash is really flexible. I can go from state to state and just sign in. And I know some people aren't familiar with DoorDash that are outside of the U.S., and DoorDash is a food delivery service. And so it's an app on your phone. And so people that are in their homes. Thank you, Sandra. What does monetization for you mean? So when you have, my DoorDash videos are fun to watch, even though they're recorded. Oh, thank you. I'm going to do some more, DoorDash videos, because those are fun. And, your son took over your YouTube account, PJ Lopez. Oh, thank you. My new puppy's cute. And any interesting stories from overnight? But absolutely, I do have some interesting overnight. Well, nothing too crazy, actually. Thankfully, I've had no like real scary stories. There was a video I made. I did get a knock, but it wasn't like a scary situation. And now I'm jumping around. So, So monetization is when you have 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 watch hours. So at that point, when the ads play, they earn, thank you, Jill, God bless you as well. The ads that play during YouTube before you're monetized, before you have the 1,000 subscribers and the 4,000 watch hours, all of those earnings from the ads go towards YouTube and the advertise. It's like a thing. But after you're monetized, some of the earnings go towards the content creator because they figure the channel's larger. And so some of the ads that just are automatically running, that goes towards the content creator. So that's what monetization is. So anything before mid-October, it was, the channel wasn't monetized. So DoorDash has been like the bulk of my earnings for 2 years, 2.5 years. And I was doing, and then the other part of that is I've greatly reduced my bills. So that was planned out. And I have a son, he graduated from high school, and I knew that once he graduated that, I wouldn't be responsible for the rent of a 2-bedroom apartment. And I was just looking at all my bills and just trying to reduce them as much as possible. So that's the flip side of that too, is that my bills are relatively low, and I've done that. That's how I'm able to travel and do DoorDash. I think it would be hard to travel DoorDash and make the type of earnings with DoorDash that I was doing before when I was renting the 2-bedroom apartment. Because I used to DoorDash 60 plus hours a week to be able to cover all the bills of renting the 2-bedroom apartment. And it would be hard to do the amount of traveling I was doing and still earn. My goal was 1,000 a week at that point. So I did that DoorDash challenge, 1,000 in 10 days, and I did it. And I took like a day off. And I also did some traveling in there. So I used to try to get 1,000 every week, for DoorDash, but I was in one area, and that's when my son was finishing high school and I had an apartment, and so I was able to do that, but I wasn't traveling around. Hopefully that clarifies a little. Yeah, I am live. time to hit the like button. Thank you. Oh, Shartawin, thank you so much. What made me start life on the road? Love from London. I'm an adventurer. I love road tripping. I love traveling. I mean, I've probably been to, I was thinking about it. I think I've been to every state throughout my life, except for Alaska and Hawaii. I really think that I've been to every state at some point. I love road trips. I love travel. I always have. I've driven across the country multiple times. Good to see you too, Char Twin. So it's just in my nature, I think, to like to travel. So, but you know, it can be, unless I was homeschooling, it could be hard to do that, raising a kid who's, you know, and my son was doing really well in the school he was at, and I didn't want to disrupt that. So, you know, that's, so we were kind of anchored in one area and just, yeah. But now that, you know, it's me and Ruby. Let's see. Oh, you want me to film Ruby's first visit to Petco? I'm happy to do that. That'd be kind of fun. Yeah, I could do that. That might be fun. Would you guys like to see Ruby's first how she does? Hi, Rosemary. You guys want another bite of cake? It's sitting here. It's like, yes, I should film it. Okay. You'd like that video? Here you go. For anybody who wants another bite of cake, just say yes. Okay. Yeah. See, the thing is, it'd be like veering off from like car life. They'd be like, wait a minute. We're following this person to get car life. And now it's like puppy going to the vet. But I love to hear that because it means that you guys are just interested in kind of like the journey. So thank you for that support. All right. Should we get some cake? She's behind me. She like squeezed herself behind me. You think other outside the van lifers will find it? Yeah. And me. I've heard Instacart is good. I think there's a wait list to sign up, and I'm not sure how it moves. I think you can move from state to state and still do Instacart. I should look into that though. That might be a little bit, it could be a little bit easier. So I did do a delivery recently and I had to cancel because it was a Safeway delivery, a pickup, and I got there and it wasn't one order. So it's hard to tell when it comes in. And I got to Safeway and it was three orders and it was like three full grocery orders. And it's like, even though I have a Honda Pilot, there's not a ton of room to like put all the orders in the car. And I had to like cancel two of them because I was like, there's no way I can have all that stuff in here. So I would have to be careful. I think with Instacart, sometimes the orders are really big. And it's not that, I mean, I could fit stuff on my bed, but it's like, I don't always want to do that because it's like having all these bags in my home. This is my home space here. So I don't always want to do that. But I don't know if Instacart shows you how big the orders are, but I've heard it's really good. So it might be worth looking into. You just started doing Uber Eats and you love it, Mama You? Nice. I used to do Uber Eats before I did it back in 2016. I did Uber Eats and that I just did Uber Eats and I did it. And so instead of like going out partying on the weekends, I was teaching, but then instead of like going out drinking on the weekends, I would do Uber driver, actually, like get passenger driving. And then Uber Eats came out and I started doing Uber Eats just, as a way to give me something to do instead of like going out to clubs and stuff. And it was great because I felt like I was like going out, except I would end up with money instead of like having spent money and drinking too much and all that. So that's kind of how I got into the Uber Eats, or the Uber Eats, and then that led to DoorDash. You finally got to be a part of the live. I'm glad. Let's do this things little, little tan tea and family. Yeah, awesome. I'm glad you were able to be a part of the live. They do show how many items. Okay, and how many miles. Oh, that's good to know, Danita. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah, she is. Shannon, she is. Yes. Yes to Petco. Okay. So when I do that, yeah, cool. I will. I'll do that for you guys. And I might put like a clip of it in the video. But I might do a whole video. We'll see. Maybe I could go live. you do Instacart in Southern California? It can be a challenge. Okay. Yeah. What makes it challenging? The size of the orders. The wear and tear. People talk a lot about that with DoorDash. And ironically, my Toyota Corolla, the car that when I was doing that 60 hours a week, the engine blew. I mean, maybe it's not ironic, but, and I'm still paying off that car. But I got that car, it had 223,000 miles, and it has over 260,000 miles. And if you look at my channel, you can see the timeline of like when I had it, and then all the door dashing, and then when the engine blew. So I do, that is a kind of a concern. And this Honda is a trooper. I wanted to acknowledge my Honda for the amount of travel and just how reliable this car has been. I appreciate this vehicle so much. It's been wonderful as a space to live out of. And then it's also just like been amazing in terms of reliabilities, except for the wiper blades. But good night, Maury. It looks like I missed a comment, but I see a lot of people saying, oh, you have to go. You're teaching tomorrow. Thanks for the cake and the company. Absolutely. Thanks for joining the live, Maury. And have fun teaching. Have a good day. Hi, Trace from Scotland. Hi, Dustin from Bellingham. Nice. Oh, yeah, Petco delivering the dog food. Yeah. Yeah, that's nice. I have a story about that. Actually, there's a video about it. I was delivering some dog food, and the person, I think his wife had ordered it, and he didn't expect anybody, although I think he was expecting someone to come pick up like an item off like OfferUp or whatever. But anyway, we startled each other. He was like, who are you? And I'm dropping off for DoorDash a pet food order, and I twisted my ankle, ended up breaking my foot. But yeah, I could see that would be like a really handy thing for people to deliver food. Yeah, Hondas are great. Toyotas are really good too. Toyota Corollas. And I kept up with all the oil changes and everything. I don't know, 260,000 plus miles is still quite a few. And, that car was great for door dashing, and it was really good on mileage. So it worked. It got me through that last year of needing, you know, earning what I needed to make. And then, now I have this car, and, yeah. So, but I do always keep that in the back of my mind. And so, you know, I have reduced my bills, so I don't have to do the same amount of door dashing, but I've also done a lot of travel. Yeah. But I'm hoping this car will keep going strong for a little while. Maybe another year at least. Do you guys want to play the game? Try this out. I don't know. So it's like cards. There are different ones, and it's like questions like, you couldn't see yourself delivering anything. Yeah, working from home. Yeah, working from home. That's, the game. Okay. So there's questions, and it looks like they have them broken into categories. Cheryl, yay. Oh, you're so excited. I'm glad you made it too. Here, for people just joining, I'll show the cake. here's the cake, the celebratory cake. And I took a slice of it. It's lemon funfetti. I squeezed some lemon juice in there, and then it's got strawberry jam, and it's got cream cheese frosting, and then strawberries on top. You're door dashing now? Yeah, I do that too. I'll watch lives. I used to do that a lot when I was doing DoorDash full time, because it was a way to like keep me company. While I was door dashing, I would have lives going. Yeah, and then so here, have a bite of cake if you'd like. Oh no. There's some of the strawberry jam and some of the funfetti and some of the frosting. Oh good. Yo, you're an hour late, Cheryl. A comment just popped up, but you're here and that's what matters. So they have these questions. You're welcome, Matt. Rubies, it's nice to watch me. Oh, you help single women like you think outside the box. Thank you for sharing this. Absolutely. Yeah, I was just thinking about thinking outside the box, actually. And I was thinking about, I think it's like human nature to want to put people into boxes, even if they're like, and no matter what, because it helps us organize our thoughts and it helps create like predictability around what to expect. So it's like, you know, it's like we want to be like, okay, put people in, but like, yeah, I think it is gluten-free. Yes. But to keep thinking outside of the box, operating outside of the box, like not, you know, it's like, that's, I think there's a lot of us that are, really thriving outside of the box. And that's kind of where our comfort is outside of the box. And so, yeah, it's cool you just said that. And I'm happy that I can help encourage you to think outside of the box. I think sometimes it's like, you know, say there's something we want to do and we don't see how we're going to get there to accomplish it. You know, a goal we have or a dream that we have or, you know, something we want to accomplish and we don't know how we'll get there logistically, financially, schedule wise, any of it. Good to see you too, Suzanne. Sherry. Hi, Sherry. Yeah, absolutely. Demi. You're in an origami shaped box. I love it. Mine's the swan shaped origami box with strawberry paper. Yeah, but there's always a way. So in those boxes, it's like, well, if you're in this box and you want to become this job or do this job or have this profession, or, you know, you have to take these steps to get there. Or if you want to, you know, live in this type of house or live in this area, here's how you have to do that to get there. And it's like, there's actually so many ways to get there. And it can be limiting to feel like, you know, there's only that one way or there's only two paths to get where you want to go. And really there's like infinite ways to get where you're going. It's just, you know, holding that focus and just keep working at it. So yeah, I'm glad I can inspire you. A super thanks came in on a video. So thank you. I don't think it's in the live, but thank you for the super thanks. I'm not sure if you're watching the live. I think it was from Jana. So there's these questions. Hi, Deborah, you just joined. And so I think these cards are broken into categories, but I'm not gonna do that. Well, I guess I could. I'm gonna shuffle them up. And so there's categories. There's like fruit, animals, and objects. Or food, animals. I'm just going to shuffle them all up. And I'm going to show you guys. You guys all have to guess. So I'm going to close my eyes and I'm going to show you a card. I'm shuffling them. I'm not looking. Yeah, game. It's called headbands, but I realize if I have it up on a headband and I'm looking, I'll be able to see it in the camera. But this way, I'll pick a card. You guys will see what it is. I'm not going to see what it is. I won't know it. You guys will know. And I'll ask questions and you guys can give me hints and I have to guess. And then we'll do it reverse. I'll look at a card and you guys will ask me questions and you have to guess. Okay? So hopefully we don't lose the internet and we can play this, and hopefully somebody stays sleeping for a little while longer and we can just get this going. Okay, you ready? You guys ready for this? I'm not looking. I have the stack and I'm just going to cut the deck here. Okay, so you guys ready to look? I'm going to hold it up. I'm going to, okay, good. Yeah? Okay. I'm not looking and I'm going to hold it up. I hope you can see it. I'm not going to look to see if you can see it. I think that you should be able to see what it is. I'm going to hold it up for a little bit so everybody can see it. Who wants to play in the game? And I'm going to hold it up for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. And now it's back in the pile. I don't know. And I'm putting the pile down. Okay. Don't say what it is. Okay. Okay. Good. Everybody got it. Okay. Good. I'm glad that it showed up. All right. Okay. So it's not an animal, right? So it's not an animal, not a food. Is it it's an object? 165,000 miles on your Toyota Corolla. Nice. Is it an object? Yes, it's an object. Okay. And it's something you wear on your head? Something you wear on your head? Is it a hat? Is it a hat? It's a hat. It's a hat? Or is it one type of hat? Is it, oh, it's a hat? Well, that was easy. Okay. That's fun. Okay. Oh, it's a type of hat. Okay. Is it, a baseball cap? Is it a baseball hat? Yeah, right. You need something half. It is a baseball hat. Okay, cool. All right. You guys were good with your clues. As soon as someone was like, it's something you wear on your head. So, okay. Should now this time I look at a card and you guys have to guess. Thank you, Jana. Another super chat, super thanks on a video. Thank you for that on the, okay. I'm going to look at one. Okay. Yeah, maybe just yes or no. Yeah, maybe yes or no. And I'll ask questions that are yes or no. Okay. Oh, okay. I picked a card. Now you guys have to guess. Okay, I have it. You guys have to guess. Yes or no questions, okay? You have to go to work, Sharon? Okay. Take care. Thanks for joining the live. Maureen asked, is it alive? Yes, it is alive. No, it's not a food, I don't think. Not usually. No, you can't wear it. Yes, it's kind of round. No, it's not a puppy. Yes, Maureen, it's a type of bug. Yeah, it's a type of bug. It is. It's an animal. Yeah. No, it's not a cat. Not a donut. Yes, it does crawl on the ground. No, it's not a June bug. No, not a ladybug. Not a butterfly. Not a roly-poly. Yeah. Someone got it. Yes, it's a spider. Ah! Creepy. It's a spider. That's a creepy spider, too. It looks like a wolf spider. Yeah. Doesn't it look like a wolf spider? Did you guys see my video about fear and the spider? It's a funny one. It's from a year and a half ago, if you scroll back. And it's about a spider, a giant spider. Okay, your turn, you guys. I'm going to hold up... right, spider. Okay, I'm going to hold a card up, you guys. And we're going to do yes or no questions. All right, I'm shuffling, and then I'm going to lift it up. I'm not looking. I hope you guys could see. You got it? Did you guys get it? Can you see? I'm going to hold it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Did you get it? Oh no, is it the spider? It's the same one? Is it a spider or the hat? It's the spider? Oh no. Okay, yeah, let's do another one. That's so weird. It's the hat. Oh, that's so funny. All right, I guess my shuffling was... That would have been really tricky though, because I wouldn't have expected it to be the same. I would have been like, well, it can't be the hat again. That's funny. Okay, I shuffled it. Like, I actually like shuffled it this time, like this. And then like this. And then I'm gonna cut the deck. It's a deck of hats and spiders, right? And then I'm gonna cut it again. There we go. All right, I'm gonna hold it up. And hopefully it's not a hat or a spider. Okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Did you guys get it? Okay. 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 So is it an object? Somebody said object. Is it an object? Is it an object? Remember yes or no question. Is it an object? I got it. It's an object. Okay. It's an object. DoorDash, they still send me these. They say it's busy in St. Petersburg, Florida. If I'd like to dash now, from when it still like sends me updates. Like, I'm not in St. Petersburg, Florida. I just got one. It's an object. Is it big? Is it bigger than me? Is it bigger than me? No, it's not. Okay, so it's smaller than me? Is it smaller than me? Yes. Okay, it's smaller than me. It comes in all sizes. Okay. I'm seeing some clues in here. Is it something that grows? Does it grow? Is it alive? That's two questions. Is it alive? I think it's flowers. I think you guys are giving me some hints. You can wear them in your hair. It smells good. I've seen these. I have it in my van. Like, is it a plant? Hi, Annie. yes and yes, it's flowers. Is it all kinds of flowers? Good morning. Good morning, Sage. Is it flowers? These are giving the answers. I know. It's okay. It's flowers. Was it one kind of flower or lots of kinds of flowers? Is it like a rose or a tulip or is it like a bouquet? Is it a bouquet or is it one kind of flower? Flowers, like a daisy, one flower. Nice. A girl on Venice Beach has that for her name. I'm gonna have more cake. It's a pink daisy. Nice. Generic flowers. Gerber a daisy. Mm-hmm. Okay, your turn, you guys. I'm shuffling. Hopefully it's not a spider. Okay. Now I'm gonna look. Okay. You guys have to guess. Yes or no questions. I'm only going to say yes or no. Do, 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 do. No, it's not a vehicle. Yes, it's alive. Yes, you can eat it. Oh, I should take those cards out of the pile. You're right. No, it's not made of wood. Not really. My time in New Orleans was fun. Yes, I guess it's an object. No, I would say no, it's not. Those of those categories, it's not the object category. Yes, it's alive at one point. At one point. No, it's not a puppy. No, it's not an animal. Hey, hanging out with Stan. The puppy's sleeping. Oh, she looks really cute right now. She's all stretched out, like her chin. No, it's not an animal. Yes, it is sweet. No, it's not a chicken. No, it's not a pet. No, it's not a mushroom. No, it's not yeast. That's a good idea. That would be hard to guess. Yeast? No, it's not broccoli. No, it's not cake. Yes, it is edible. Hanging out with Stan, thank you. Thank you for that. I appreciate the super chat. No, not beef sticks. No, it's not a vegetable. Yes, it is a plant. No, it doesn't live in the ocean. No, it's not a strawberry. No, not an apple. You guys are getting closer though. Oh, no, not a banana. And yes, it is a type of fruit, Nor. Yeah. Yes, a type of fruit. No, it's not an orange. Yeah, it is a type of fruit. Yes, it is a type of fruit. It is round. It's not a grape. Oh, sorry, Matt. The chat goes too fast and you're tired. We'll do just a couple more of these and then we can just go back to just some questions. But no, it's not an orange, not a kiwi, not a peach, not a blueberry, not a pear. Hey, you guys know a lot of fruits. Now I'm getting hungry for some fruit salad. No, not a nectarine, not a kiwi, not a mango, not a pomegranate. Oh my gosh, it's so tricky. No, I'm not seeing it. No, it's not a berry. No, not a coconut, not a peach, not a plum, not a lemon. Kind of like 20 questions, not a plum. It's a game called Headbands. So it's, yeah, a guessing game. So there's a fruit here that you guys are guessing. I saw what it was and now you guys are guessing. Barbara, yeah, welcome. Not an apple, not a grapefruit. I don't know. Exotic. It probably depends. Not a coconut, not a strawberry. Oh my gosh. yes, Dustin, it's a cherry. Cherries. Yep. Maureen. Yeah. You guys got it. Yeah. Cherry. Yes. Yep, cherries. That was tricky. You guys came up with so many fruits. Oh my gosh. Cherry. You said cherry too? Awesome. Good job. Woohoo. Okay. So should we do like maybe one more each round? And then we'll wake up somebody here. You were way off. You guys did well. You came up with a lot of fruits. Yeah. You only said two fruits and then one of them was the cherry. Okay. You did name so many. I didn't know there were so many fruits until you guys reminded me. All right. I'm shuffling again. Oh, wait, I should have taken that out, but I haven't. Next time I'll take them out. Hi, Reverend Rashim. Good afternoon. Well, thank you. All right. So I'm shuffling. I'm going to show it to you guys. You guys see it? Okay, ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Did you get it? You got it. Okay. It was so cute because she's asleep, but her tail was, I was like, what is that noise? She's like dreaming. I got to show you guys really quickly. Yeah, don't say what it is, guys. I'll ask yes or no questions, but look at her first. And her tail was wagging a moment ago. See her? She's dreaming. She's dreaming of running. Normally she looks all brown, but you guys can see her. That's like the healer, I think. The spots. She's probably nursing in her sleep. Nursing and running. You can see her paws are moving. Pretty cute. I really want to rub her belly, but I don't want to wake her up. Okay. Do you guys remember what it is? Yeah, she is. She's having sweet dreams. She'll probably get in between like a healer and a lab, like a medium-sized dog, like not as big as a lab. A small lab, maybe. That's what I'm hoping, but I guess time will tell how big she'll get. And her birthday was 12/31/23, which is kind of cool. So it's like 1/2/3/1/2/3. So 12/31/23. I think that's kind of neat. Yeah. Okay, so is it an object? Uh-oh, am I cutting out again? It's buffering. Uh-oh. No, it's not an object. Okay. Is it an animal? Is it an animal? No? Yes, it's an animal. Okay. Is it bigger than me? Is it bigger than me? Yes? Okay. Does it live in the woods? Yes, it lives in the woods. Sometimes it lives in the woods. Do they have them in, do they have them in the west coast of the U.S.? Oh, hanging out with Stan, they're giving it away. Okay. I think I know what it is. Oh, thank you. Thank you for the super chat. Thank you, Sylvia. Your hubby got you a mug for Valentine's Day. Oh, that's awesome. Well, happy Valentine's Day. That's so sweet. And, thanks. Thank you. It's your first super chat on a live stream. I feel honored that your first super chat is on my this live stream here, and also that you ordered that you got a mug. That's really sweet. And enjoy. I hope that mug brings you a lot of joy or whatever. Was it I choose joy? I choose cake? I choose peace? Yes, it's on the West Coast. Oh yeah, Cheryl. That's a good idea. Yeah. So it's on, is it a bear? I'm just going to say, cause I think I know now. So rather than pretending I don't know, it's, yeah. Is it a bear? I got it. It's a bear. Okay. You think I'm psychic? I think you guys are giving some hints. It's a bear. Okay, good. A grizzly bear specifically. Okay. We're going to do one more. And it's going to be you guys. Hi, Deborah. Welcome. Okay. We're going to do one more. I helped you get through your surgery, Suzanne. Well, thank you. That's that means a lot. And I'm really glad. And I hope that you have a quick recovery from your surgery. And I'm really glad that I was able to help you get through your surgery. That means a lot. Okay, one more, you guys. Somebody's getting up here. This one's for you guys. And let's see. Okay. I have it. So you guys got to guess what it is. Only yes or no questions, remember. I'm only going to say yes or no. What were the groups again? It's object, animal, or food. No, it's not an object. And no, it's not alive. No, it's not an animal. Yes, it is a food. It's a food. Somebody's awake but sleepy still. It is a food. No, it's not pizza. No, it's not a tomato. No, it's not pasta. It is sweet. It is sweet. Yes, it is a pastry. No, it's not cake. No, it's not eggs. Nope, not curry. It's a sweet pastry. It is, Lisa. It's a donut. Lisa got it. It's a donut. And Cheryl, yes, it's a donut. Yep, a donut. Baked goods, yes. A donut. With sprinkles. I was like, how appropriate. How appropriate. And then somebody's awake. Somebody's awake. Puppy breath kisses. And I probably need to take her outside. So, yeah. Party time. We get lots of kisses. Oh, thank you, Wendy Lindy. Thank you. Thank you for the super chat. I appreciate that. And I like the hippopotamuses. I like those. Ruby. She has like no idea what the camera is or like looking at the camera. I realize it's probably easier to like make videos with her rather than like on the live. Because with the videos, I can like aim the camera at her. You like the game? Good. Well, we can do more of the game. I'll keep it. I have that deck of cards and that was fun. Yeah. And my battery, it says 20%. Yeah, I am gonna take her out for a walk and I think I'll end the live. Thank you for sharing the cake with me and for sharing some time. Ruby is very soft. Yeah. I wish I could really share this with you guys, and I'm probably gonna have cake all day for my meal. For my food for the day will be cake. I'm glad you had fun and you liked the game. Good. Yeah. I enjoyed that too, and we can do it again. And your Max says hi to Ruby. Hi, Max. We say hi too. Yeah, I think maybe it'll be fun. Someday down the road, I can do international travel with Ruby. I know that, I think that's a thing. I think you can bring your dog overseas. You just want to give so many kisses. So I am going to bring her out and walk her around a little bit, but thank you guys for hanging out. I had a lot of fun and thanks for being a part of this channel. It's a beautiful thing. So you guys are awesome. Enjoy the rest of your Sunday, and I'll be doing the Q&A video pretty soon. And I will film when I bring her on Tuesday to the vet. And I don't know how I'll integrate that into a video or what, but I will film that. Yeah, absolutely. And I will probably do another live next Sunday. Yeah, I hope everybody enjoys the rest of their day and I'll see you guys soon. And you wanna say bye, Ruby? She's squirmy, she wants to go outside. Okay, bye you guys. Thank you. And I'll see you soon.